We have a health alert for you this morning. Robots in Midtown Memphis are creating better doctors for the entire world.
A bit later this month, a new $40 million teaching center opens at UT's Health Science Center in Midtown Memphis, using the newest technology to train medical students. And Dr. Chad Epps is with UTHSC. Hi. Good to have you.
Thank you.
Welcome.
So you're also using virtual reality, right?
We are.
Okay, well, let's start with the robots. How does that work? How
so we don't call them robots. We call them mannequins.
Mannequins. Sorry.
Yes, okay. But they are. We have mannequins of different degrees of fidelity. So some are very basic, and students and residents can practice procedures on them.
Okay.
And some of them are very advanced. They breathe, their chest moves, they have heart sounds.
Now
that's
a robot, Chad.
They have pulses, their eyes open and closed.
Really?
Yeah.
They can talk.
So why use this?
Well, it gives students and residents an opportunity to practice in a setting where they can't cause injury or harm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So it's actually a safe environment for people to learn.
So we were looking right then, there's one of the robots.
Yes.
Are some of them so extensive that, like, you could actually do some surgical procedures on
them? You absolutely can. We do have some mannequins that you can do surgical procedures on.
So, doctor, is this being done anyplace else in the country
this
way, or how unique is this?
It's pretty unique. I mean, simulation is not new to the world of healthcare education. However, you know, having a standalone building that's dedicated solely to simulation is actually really rare. There's only a handful of these in the country.
Right, and you also have so many of these mannequins that there's not a backup, of students.
Yes, yes.
So what about, how are you using virtual reality?
So we have areas of virtual reality that we use for training. So some of the surgical training, for instance, so surgeons who are learning to do laparoscopic or minimally invasive surgeries, and there's a skill associated with using those tools.
Right.
And so they can practice that in a virtual environment where they feel like and see as if they were actually doing the surgery, but they're doing it on a virtual reality.
That is amazing. So, doctor, what does this say about the future and the direction we're going in today, and with this technology being right here in Memphis, Tennessee?
Right. Well, it's all about improving the way we deliver health care. So if we can bring students, residents, and even practicing staff, physicians, nurses, into the simulated setting and have them practice there, demonstrate competency there before they actually go and do things on site.
And what differences have you already seen? What are some of the doctors in training, what are they telling you about this? What are they like or maybe not like about it? How are they feeling about
this? They do feel like they're much more prepared when they go and see patients and start to do procedures that they've not done before.
Yeah. As this grows, this may be a really stupid question, but as this grows more prevalent, could this potentially shorten a residency time?
Well, potentially. So there are a lot of discussions around how we substitute simulation for clinical time.
Sure.
And most people feel like the substitution is not a one-to-one. An hour spent in the simulation is probably much more dense experience compared to the real clinical setting.
Wow.
So, for instance, a nursing student can go out and do a clinical rotation, but they may, you kind of have to wait until something presents itself.
Right.
However, in
makes
simulation,
sense.
We can really standardize the experience for everyone.
What about from a patient standpoint? What do you want him or her to feel about a process like this, knowing that some of these doctors have this training?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I tell the story. I'm an anesthesiologist, and the first time I did an epidural was on a live woman who was in labor, who had no idea that it was my first time, right?
Really?
So you were terrified.
Exactly. But she didn't know. But what patients should know is that we're now training healthcare providers that are demonstrating competency in simulation before they're coming to practice on them.
So this could mean or make for fewer mistakes?
Absolutely. It's all about patient safety and improving healthcare.
Absolutely huge. Yeah. And if we can shorten the span of education time, we can create more doctors across. That's
awesome. Absolutely.